Perhaps we learn the most important life lessons in our childhood. Time and tide waits for none, or time is money. That is what we will learn today. The time value of money, or the money value of time.
Hello everyone, I'm Farhadhussein Masoom, and today we are going to talk about discounted cash flow analysis, also known as the time value of money. A very important topic in our day-to-day lives, and also in my field, forest economics. The concept of time is crucial in forest management because forestry is a game of patience. You prepare your site and plant this year, fertilize in a different year, and harvest probably quarter to half a century later. When to harvest is also a really important question, but I guess the real question is, how do we compare income and costs that occur over time? That is exactly what we're going to learn today. Let's start with the basics so that everyone is on the same page. Let's begin with the concept of interest rate. Money today is worth more than money tomorrow. If you ask me, hey, give me $10,000 today, I will give it back to you 2 years from now. That is not happening unless you are a very good friend. Because if I put $10,000 in the bank today, the bank will give me more than $10,000 2 years from now. How much more? That will depend on interest rate. If I put $10,000, that's called my principal, capital P, and the money is growing at a simple annual interest rate of 4%, we call it R, then every year I will get $400, which is P multiplied by R. Then in 2 years, I will get $800 in interest. Just multiply P, R, and T. Therefore, the total amount I will receive at the end, which is called future value or amount accrued and expressed by capital A, is simply my principal and interest put together. I know that interest is PRT, so I can rewrite the amount accrued as A is equal to P multiplied by 1 plus RT. Now you can argue that, hey, wait, after the first year, my amount accrued was $10,400. Why did you give me the same $400 as interest for the second year? Give me interest on my interest. And you would be right. That's why we entered the realm of compound interest rate. Compounding is the process where interest is accrued not only on the principal, but also on the interest. To calculate that, we introduce another variable n, which indicates how many times money will grow or compound in a year. For now, let's just say money will grow once every year. We will see what happens when money increases monthly shortly. The formula to compute A with compound interest rate is P multiplied by 1 plus R over n to the power n multiplied by t. And we see that we actually get about $16 more with compound interest. If money grows every month, then simply change n to 12. Now we get $831 more. Now this estimate is approximately true, not exactly true. For that, you have to calculate the effective rate, in which I'm not going into today. You can read about it in the book Forest Management, page 339 to 340. Anyway, you probably have noticed that when n is 1, which means compounded annually one time, then we can simplify the formula such as this. And it provides the same results, of course. From this point onwards, we will only talk about annual compound interest rate. There is a federal law that requires the commercial interest rates to be reported as an annual interest rate. Otherwise, it becomes too confusing for the consumers and they cannot make a choice based on what is going on. Now we know how to calculate future value. Let's reverse the game. How do we calculate present value from the future? Well, we saw the formula for future value. We can invert it and calculate present value. Imagine that the interest rate is 4%, compounded annually. If t is equal to 0, present value is equal to the future value. $10,000 today is exactly $10,000, no matter what the interest rate is. But $10,000 a year from now is worth $9,615 this year, or $9,246 if it is coming from year two. As T increases, or further in the future the money is coming from, the less it is worth today. So if you give me $10,000 each year for 3 years, the present value of all amounts will be discounted to $28,861. That's why this process is called discounting. A process to determine present value of payment or stream of payments. This is the basis of discounted cash flow analysis. This interest thing is really interesting. $10,000 every year for the rest of your life at 4% interest rate is just $250,000 today. This is called the present value of perpetuity, or perpetual annuity. And you can calculate that by principal P over interest rate R, a very simple formula. If it is not perpetual, if it is only for a fixed number of years, then the equation becomes a little bit more messy. Suppose you win a lottery, $100 million. Now the authority told you that you can choose between two options. One, you can get $10 million each year for 10 years, or you can get a lump sum of $65 million right now. Which option will you choose? We see that at 4% interest rate, $10 million every year for 10 years is $81 million today. I will definitely go for the installment option. Have you ever wondered why is it called the interest rate? The word interest comes from the Latin word interest, means compensation for loss. Basically, if you're lending out money now and getting it back later, you should be compensated. And in Anglo-French, it means legal concern. Basically, you can say that if you lend money, you have an interest in that and you can collect it. Use of this concept became really popular in the beginning of the 20th century, but the concept existed in some form since the 13th century. Famous mathematician Leonardo Fibonacci showed the calculation of interest rate in his book Liberabaci. Yes, the same guy after whom the famous Fibonacci series was named. I first learned about him in the book Da Vinci Code by Dan Brown. Enough history. Let's look at some forestry examples. Example 1. You invested $100 in a forest stand today and you plan to harvest the forest in year 25. How much money do you have to make to break even at 4% interest rate? Your P is 100, R is 0.04, and T is 25. You want to know how much money you need from the future such that there is no loss or no profit. In other words, break even. Simple. You know the future value formula, plug P, R, and T, and voila, you need about $267. What if you want to harvest in year 30? Obviously, you need more if it is coming from further in the future. What if interest rate increases to 6%? Of course, you need more from the same year because it is being discounted more. Example 2. Suppose you will get $250 more at year 25 if I spend $100 for fertilization at year 2. Interest rate is 4%. Should I do it? First, I need to convert everything to present value so that I compare apples and apples. And yeah, it seems that I should do it. As long as it is greater than $92.46, sure. Your return or earning depends heavily on this interest rate. That's why it's also called the earning rate, or the actual rate or internal rate of return, and expressed as IRR. I'm sure you can guess the formula for interest rate. We can find it out from the future value formula. This formula is valid if our principal is in year zero. If different estimates come from different years, we just need to acknowledge that difference in time. Let's take the previous example, but formulate it in a different way. If I spend $100 for fertilization in year two, I will get $250 more at year 25, so marginal increase is 250. What's my internal rate of return? You can probably guess that it is a little over 4%. Now we are ready to find out the most important number of all, the holy grail of discounted cash flow analysis, the glorious, the great NPV, net present value. It is the present value of all the benefits minus all the costs. Companies make decisions between multiple options based on this number, whichever option gives you the higher NPV. Forest landowners, if profit is their primary objective, they do the same. If the landowner spends $100 in the first year, year zero, $200 in year two, and earns $1,000 in year 20, what is the NPV? I put costs as negative and earning as positive, make all the values present value, and sum it up. Landowner's NPV is about $171. Pretty simple, but very powerful. This is how Dr. Pete Bettinger, one of the authors of the book Forest Management, describes why discounted cash flow analysis is important. Dr. Pete Bettinger for you.
Hello, everyone. Please try to remember not to discount economics. Take an interest in it. Otherwise, your problems will only be compounded in the future. And I wish you all the best.
And he's right, isn't he? It has real life implications. I just bought this 2021 RAV4 XLE Premium, and something interesting happened in the dealership about the interest rate. I looked at different dealerships, made them compete against each other for a good out-the-door competitive price. And I finally found one. I thought it was a good deal. I sat down with their finance guy, they ran my credit history, and I qualified for a 0% interest rate. But then they told me that if I want the 0% interest rate, then I have to add $1,250 to my principal. And if I don't want that $1,250 to my principal, my interest rate will be 3.39%. I did my present value calculation right then and there and found out that the 0% interest rate estimate is still cheaper, even though it adds $1,250 to my principal. And obviously, I did not pay the added $1,250. And I told them that both of their options are unfair because 0% interest rate should not add anything else, should not penalize me in my principal. It should be equal to the cash value. When they tried to tell me some more nonsense about interest rate, I told them, come on, I literally have a PhD in this. Well, I don't exactly have a PhD in interest rate, but my PhD research included calculations of compounding and discounting.
There are companies who will hire you if you can do this well. Many make their career out of it. Banks rely heavily upon it. If you are a forestry consultant and your job is to help landowners make economic decisions, you cannot ignore it. We are towards the end of our lecture. Before giving out an assignment, let me just summarize the main points, the summaries of discounted cash flow analysis. Number one, money tomorrow is not the same as money today. You need to discount it. Number two, if you are owed money, then it's better to get it now. And if you owe money, it's better to delay the payment. Let's look at an assignment. You have growth and yield data for loblolly pine developed by Carbon Resources Science Center, University of Florida. You can see availability of different types of timber at a given stand age, up to 100 years. Costs and prices are as follows. Interest rate is 4%. Your task is to find out when the landowner should harvest if profit is the primary objective.
That's all from me today. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. See you in the next one.